Visual Learning, Neuroanatomy Series. The story of cranial nerves with visual mnemonics. The three simple rules you should keep in mind when watching these videos. First of all, just relax and relieve yourself from any stress related to learning and anatomy. 2. You don't have to take any notes. Thirdly, don't try to memorize or force anything. Just watch, have fun, and everything will come naturally. At the end of these video lectures you will have the superpower of knowing 1. The names and the corresponding number of each cranial nerve in any order. 2. You will know with ease all the structures they innervate and all the types of fibers each of these nerves contains, out of 7 possible. 3. You will know the 7 types of cranial nerves, nuclei in the brainstem and the corresponding nuclei of each cranial nerve. What is a nerve? A nerve is an enclosed, cable-like bundle of axon in the peripheral nervous system. Now, let's have a very quick look at the 7 general rules about the cranial nerves. 1. Cranial nerves are nerves that emerge from CNS, above C1 level, the first spinal nerve. But there's an exception. 2. There are 12 pairs of cranial nerves. None of them is located in the midline, but each one of them is located at the two sides of the midline, forming a mirror image of each other. 4. They are assigned using Roman numerals, 1 to 12. The numbering of the cranial nerves is based on the order in which they emerge from the brain, from up to down, from the front to the back. 5. They don't innervate only the head and neck structures, but also some structures in the trunk, like most of visceral organs from vagus nerve, cranial nerve. 10. 6. In reality the first two cranial nerves, olfactory and optic nerve, which emerge from the cerebrum or forebrain, are not real cranial nerves. They are just forward extension of brain tissue. The remaining cranial nerves arise from the brain stem. Since the first two CN are extensions of brain, their myelin sheath is created by oligodendrocytes, compared to Schwann cells for the remaining other nerves. So any myelinating disease affecting the central nervous system, multiple sclerosis for example, will only affect the first two CN, not the others. And any myelinating disease affecting the peripheral nervous system, Guillain-Barré syndrome, will not affect the first two CN, but only the remaining nerves. 7. There is no such thing as pure motor nerves, because for example, the pure motor nerves also contain some afferent proprioceptive fibers. But for didactic and anatomical clinical purpose, we classify the CN into 3 categories, motor, sensory, both containing motor and sensory fibers. Now, let's see the 7 types of possible fibers a nerve can have. We said that each CN may contain motor fibers, efferent, sensory fibers, afferent, or both motor and sensory fibers. There are different types of neurons, but all the sensory fibers will always contain a bundle of unipolar, T-shaped, neurons stacked together. The body of unipolar neurons will stack together forming a sensory ganglion. So if a nerve contains 1 of 4 sensory fibers, it will always contain a sensory ganglion, which is the station where the unipolar sensory neuron cell bodies reside. These motor or sensory fibers can innervate either somatic structures or visceral structures. The visceral fibers are controlled by the autonomic nervous system, parasympathetic and sympathetic. The good news is that all CN contain only parasympathetic fibers. Why? The parasympathetic system fibers emerge from the brain stem, just like cranial nerves, and from the sacral region of spinal cord, S2 to S4, while the sympathetic nervous system fibers emerge from thoracic and lumbar region of the spinal cord, C8 to L3. So CN which emerge from the brainstem contain only parasympathetic fibers. The preganglionic parasympathetic fibers, which emerge from the brainstem, travel to the parasympathetic ganglia. The ganglia are close to the effector organ, parasympathetic equals perivisceral, peri equals around or near the organ. From the ganglia, emerge the postganglionic fibers, much shorter than the preganglionic fibers, which then innervate the effector organ. So, if a nerve contains parasympathetic fibers, it will always contain a parasympathetic ganglion, which is the station where the preganglionic and postganglionic fibers synapse. These somatic or visceral fibers may innervate some special structures or general structures. Theoretically, there should be 8 types of fibers, but, since there are no special somatic efferent fibers, in reality there are only 7 types of fibers, 3 motor fibers, general somatic efferent, special visceral, efferent, general visceral, efferent, and 4 sensory fibers, special somatic afferent, general somatic afferent, special visceral, afferent, general visceral, afferent. Remember, don't worry if right now, some of you got a little confused or overwhelmed. You don't need to memorize any of these right now, because I will explain each fiber, one by one and step by step in other videos, when I talk about each cranial nerve. For now, just relax, and enjoy the ride. Imagine now, that each of the 7 snow white dwarfs, represents, a unique and specific CN, nucleus for each of the 7 different types of fibers. Then each fiber will be connected to its specific nucleus. So if a nerve, has, 1 type of fiber, it will have, just 1 nucleus. But if, for example, a nerve is 4 types of fibers, it will also, have, 4 central connections to each specific nucleus, for each specific fiber. This was all about the 7 types of possible fibers a nerve can have. Next is a short introductory video for cranial nerves 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6. If you liked this video, please share it with your friends. Follow me on social media. Link is in the description. Feel free to add a comment below if you have any question or suggestion. And finally, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.